are here with Congressman Mark Vesey. Thank you for just taking some time to speak with us and just share a little bit about your journey. So what I'm trying to do in politics is just get more people involved in what's going on and get to know our elected officials. So a lot of people feel like you guys are elite, untouchable. We can't you know, feel you and see you. So the reason we created this is so we can get to know you guys better.
Right.
So tell me a little bit more about your district, where you represent, and like when you started to run and all of that.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Hey, guys. Sorry. Hey, everybody. How's everybody doing out there? Again, my name is Mark Vesey, Congressman for the 33rd Congressional District. I was raised here in the Metroplex in Fort Worth, and this is my third term in Congress.
Did you always want to be in politics?
Yeah, I wanted to be in politics at a young age.
Really?
Yeah, I wanted to be in politics at a young age. So my family is from a little community called Como, which is just west of here.
Okay.
Maybe about from here, about 12, 13 minutes west of here, west of downtown Fort Worth. A little small black community. Mm-hmm. And my uncle was a, my late uncle now, he was a staffer for Jim Wright. For those viewers out there that may not know who Jim Wright is, Jim Wright was a congressman who represented the 12th Congressional District based in Fort Worth.
Okay.
And in 1976, he became the majority leader of the U.S. House of Representatives and served in that role for about 10 years. And then when Tip O'Neill retired, he became the Speaker of the House. So my uncle worked for him.
Okay.
And I asked my uncle one day, I said, I was watching a White House press conference. I asked my uncle one day, I said, hey, how did that woman get that job? The one, the lady was answering questions. And you know, thinking back on it, it may have actually been a State Department, but I remember it was a woman.
Mm-hmm.
And my uncle said, she answers questions for the president without making him look bad. And I was fascinated with that.
Okay.
I was in the 8th grade, and I just became like fascinated with that.
Yeah.
And I said, well, what did she go to college for? And he said, well, she probably went to college and majored in mass communication, journalism, broadcast journalism. She probably majored in something like that.
Yeah.
And maybe she was even a journalist herself, because she knows how to deal with the press. The most important aspect of that job is knowing how to deal with the press.
Mm-hmm.
And I just became really just fascinated with politics from that point on.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Now, of course, you know, being in 8th grade, you become fascinated with a lot of different things before you finally decide you want to do that.
Right.
So at one point, I thought I wanted to, you know, kick down doors and be a U.S. Marshal and be in the FBI.
Okay.
There was a movie called Wall Street.
Yeah.
That came out in 1987 that was like very popular.
Okay.
And every kid in high school, you know, who wanted to be an investment banker.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, of course, you know, again, you know, being 14, 15, 16 years old, your mind changes a lot, but I always had in mind that at some point I was going to work in politics.
Really? So then where'd you go to college?
I went to college at Texas Wesleyan University.
Okay.
Which is not too far from here. And majored in mass communication.
So now tell me about family, like wife, kids.
Yeah, I have a wife that is here. I think that you know my wife.
Yeah.
And she owns her own business here in Fort Worth.
Correct.
And I have a son that is 11 years old.
Oh, okay.
Yes, and so we're very proud Fort Worth natives. And my son goes to public school here in Fort Worth.
Okay.
And we really.
Do they know who you are when you go to school?
Oh yeah.
They give you 5-star treatment.
No. I rarely go to the school, but yeah.
But the principal and all the teachers, they know that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but they treat me a lot of love.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Good. So then
which is good because you want your child's educational and social experience to be normal.
Yeah.
That's really important.
Definitely. Yeah. Okay. Well, I think we're going to some lunch spot.
Yeah, lunch, dinner, breakfast.
Yeah. Okay.
You got what I need.